across the country and indeed the region. This is the News at 9. I'm Chris Higenyi. We begin our news broadcast tonight with news from Tanzania, where a new president has taken the reins of office 48 hours after the death of John Pombe Magufuli. Samia Suluhu Hassan was sworn in at a ceremony in the commercial capital, Dar es Salaam, amid pomp and ceremony, but in a very, very somber circumstance. Let's have the details in the following report.
Taking the oath.
Mimi Samia Suluhu Hassan naapa kwamba nitakuwa mwaminifu.
I, Samia Suluhu Hassan, promise to be honest and obey and protect the Constitution of Tanzania, said Hassan, dressed in a black suit and red headscarf before dignitaries at the ceremony in the commercial capital, Dar es Salaam.
E Mwenyezi Mungu nisaidie.
In her first public address as president, the 61-year-old leader announced 21 days of mourning for Magufuli and public holidays on March 22nd and on March 25th, the day the late president will be buried.
Nchi yetu itakuwa katika kipindi cha maombolezo kwa siku 21.
Hassan ascended to the presidency after President Magufuli's death due to heart disease was announced by the government on Wednesday, more than 2 weeks after he was last seen in public.
We lost our leader, President of the Republic of Tanzania, the Honorable Dr. John Pombe Joseph Magufuli, who parted this life from heart complications in hospital in Dar es Salaam.
The 61-year-old is affectionately known as Mama Samia in Tanzania culture that reflects the respect she is held in rather than reducing her to a gendered role. Magufuli's absence since February 27th had fueled speculation about his health and sparked rumors he had contracted COVID-19, although officials had denied he was ill.
Tanzanians should be at peace. Your president is around, healthy, working hard. To spread rumors that he is sick is just an outcome of hate.
According to Tanzania's constitution, the vice president serves out the remainder of the term of a president who dies in office.
Vice President Samia Suluhu Hassan takes over as interim president until 2025, when a new election will be held.
Magufuli, who was first elected in 2015, secured a second 5-year term in polls in October last year.
John Pombe Joseph Magufuli. Na hapa kwamba nitakuwa mwaminifu kwa Jamhuri ya Muungano wa Tanzania.
The constitution also states that after the consultation with their party, the new president will propose a deputy, the choice to be confirmed by the votes of no fewer than 50% of the National Assembly. First elected as Magufuli's running mate in 2015, she was re-elected last year along with him, and according to the constitution, she should serve out the rest of the 5-year term in the top job. But she was a surprise choice for a running mate in 2015, leaping over several other more prominent politicians in the Chama cha Mapinduzi party, which has been in power in one form or another since independence in 1961. First elected to public office in 2000, she came to national prominence in 2014 as the vice president of the Constituent Assembly, created to draft a new constitution. Her calm demeanor in managing occasional outbreaks of chaos and the way in which she dealt with some of the more outspoken members earned her recognition. In terms of personality, she strikes a contrast with Magufuli, where he appeared impulsive, not afraid to speak off the cuff and let his feelings be known. She is more thoughtful and considered. She is also said to be a good listener who believes in following the correct procedures. There was no doubt that she was loyal to the president, but she was not afraid to strike out on her own. Perhaps the most significant evidence of that was in 2017 when she visited opposition leader Tundu Lissu in hospital in the Kenyan capital, Nairobi, after he survived an assassination attempt. With people speculating that state agents had been involved, the pictures of the visit sent shockwaves through the country. Before her taking over office, other past female African women presidents include 1993 to 1994 Sylvie Kinigi, caretaker president of Burundi, following the killing of Melchior Ndadaye, 2006 to 2018 Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, elected president of Liberia, 2009 Rose Franchi Nrogombe, interim president of Gabon following the death of Omar Bongo, 2012 Monique Ousseine Belepu, acting president of Mauritius after the resignation of Sir Anirudh Jugnauth, 2012 to 2014 Joyce Banda, president of Malawi after the death of Bingu wa Mutharika, 2014 to 2016 Catherine Samba Panza, transitional president of Central African Republic, elected by parliament, 2015 to 2018 Amina Grip Fakim, president of Mauritius, elected by parliament, and 2018 to present, Saliwak Zewudi, president of Ethiopia, elected by parliament.